ओके स्टूडेंट, आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 1D. फॉर ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन इक्वेशंस स्टेट द टू वेरिएबल्स विच आर इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू ईच अदर एंड एक्सप्लेन योर आंसर. ओके, बिफोर सॉल्विंग दिस क्वेश्चन I have to explain you something, then you the solution of this question will be easier for you. This is your pre-exercise work, but you don't have to note down anywhere in your register. It is just for your explanation. If x is inversely proportional to y, what we will do? X equals to k upon y, and we move this y on the other hand side of the equals to, and it will make xy equals to k. Here k is a constant, k is a constant. So what I am trying to explain you, that when two variables are inversely proportional, their product is always a constant. Okay, by using this concept I am going to solve question number 3. In the first part of question number 3, we have y equals to 3 upon x square. So when we move this x square on the other hand side of the equals to, we will get y x square equals to 3. And here 3 is a constant. So we can write y is inversely proportional to x square, or y and x square are inversely proportional to each other. In B part of question number 3, we have y equals to 1 upon root x. We have to move this root x on the other hand side of the equation. So y root x equals to 1. Here 1 is a constant. Y is inversely proportional to root x. You can write your answer in both ways. Okay, so I am not going to do C and D part. This is your homework. I am going to do this E part of question number 3. Here q equals to 4 upon p plus 1 whole square. Whatever you have in your denominator, you have to move the whole thing on the other hand side. Q multiplied by p plus 1 whole square equals to 4. Here 4 is constant. So in this case q is inversely proportional to p plus 1 whole square. This q is inversely proportional to this term. Okay, so you have to complete this question number 3.